Could you imagine making an extra $10,000 in a year? That breaks down to roughly $833 per month that you would need to earn, and it's actually more achievable than you think. In this video, we are covering 10 crazy, extreme ways to make $10,000. Hey guys, welcome back to the College Investor, investing and personal finance for millennials. Now, when I say crazy ways to make $10,000, I really do mean crazy. People have done it and it can be done again. So let's cover this top 10 list of ways you can make $10,000. Starting with number one, selling pretty much everything you own. Think furniture, electronics, household goods. Basically, if it isn't nailed down, you can sell it. And while many people are like, I have to have a TV in my apartment or I have to have a sofa in my living room, could you go without one? Could you actually sell these things? People are having a ton of success selling on places like Facebook Marketplace or Craigslist and more. So consider selling your stuff. Number two is to rent out your space. Now, when I say space, that could mean a couple of different things. First, if you have an extra closet, an extra bedroom, maybe you have a storage unit or a basement that you're not really utilizing, you can actually rent out those spaces for people who need to use them to store different things. You could also use your driveway. Think about RV spots and renting out your driveway for a person to park their RV, or maybe you have a really awesome backyard that you can rent out for Airbnb campers or special events. The third way is to rent out your car or rent out your stuff. So you can actually rent out your car, especially if you aren't driving a lot these days. You can rent out your car using a platform called Turo. As long as you meet the qualifications on that website, you are free to rent out your car to other people and make money at it. You can also rent your stuff. So if you have power tools, equipment, a trailer, just about anything that you want to use to rent, you can do so using platforms like Loanable. Loanable is so cool because you can find people in your area that are renting their stuff and then you can rent from them. And likewise, you can rent your own things and rent towards other people. I actually saw somebody wanting to rent a bouncy house for kids. I'm like, that's a great idea. You can just rent that out and you don't have to worry about it going to waste sitting in storage. The fourth way is to start partnering with Lyft by becoming a Lyft driver. So according to Aliva, you can earn up to $19 an hour working as a Lyft driver. So if you're really working towards that $833 per month in additional earnings to hit that 10K in a year, then that means you only have to drive about 44 hours per month with Lyft, which breaks down to roughly 11 hours a week of driving. So that actually doesn't seem that crazy of a way to make an extra $10,000 if you ask me. The fifth way to make an extra 10K does sound a little extreme to me. Think about game shows and sweepstakes. Okay, so a lot of people actually don't apply to be on these game shows, but you don't know unless you try. And there is mad money to be earned in game shows and likewise with sweepstakes. Sweepstakes is different than a contest because a contest, you actually have certain rules that you have to adhere to and then you're judged on whatever your entry is for that contest. A sweepstakes is you just simply enter and then see if you win. Now, there are a ton of sweepstakes online that you can get into. In fact, we had one right here on thecollegeinvestor.com where we gave away a $500 Amazon gift card. So look for ways, sign up. There are several platforms that you can use, including Sweetie Sweeps, Contest Girl, online sweepstakes, giveaway promo, and Reddit giveaways. Now, the sixth way to make an extra 10K is one of my favorites, and that is to get your freelance hustle on. Basically, think about whatever skill set that you have right now, and if you are being paid for those skill sets right now in your day job, you can freelance that out. So this could include freelance writing, content creation, social media, graphic design, finances, organization. Maybe you're really good at style and interior design. Anything that you already have a skill at can be freelanced. So you can think about those skills, write your top three skills on a piece of paper, and then start networking and reaching out to your personal and professional network and let them know that you're available to do side gigs as a freelancer. It works. The seventh way is to invest in real estate by pooling your money using crowdfunding sources. Now, crowdfunding real estate is a really nice option because then you don't have to put as much money up as you would if you were just doing this by yourself. So crowdfunding lets you pool your money with a group of people, and then together you would purchase that property, and then you'll get a portion of whatever income that property makes, and then as that property appreciates when it gets sold, then you also get the earnings. Check out Realty Mogul if you're interested in crowdfunding real estate opportunities. The eighth way that you can earn an extra $10,000 is to lend money to others. And I'm not talking about lending this to your sister. I'm talking about using third-party platforms where you can put up your money as a personal loan, and then you get to select what your terms are, how long you want to loan your money out, and then what type of interest that you want to earn on that. And there are several options on different platforms. And then that micro loan or whatever loan amount you want to give, then you get paid back that principal plus interest. So basically you're the bank in this situation and you're lending out your money to other people using a third party platform. Now the main companies in this space are Prosper and Lending Club. So be sure to check them out if you're interested in this type of way to earn additional income. But keep in mind, you'll need money up front in order to make money to make this whole process work. Number nine is also one of my favorite ways to earn money, and that is start a money-making blog or website. And that's exactly how The College Investor started in the beginning. Just started as a humble blog, and it has grown to what you see today. And while a blog isn't an overnight success, you're definitely going to have to work at it and continue to come up with content ideas and strategy and plugging in different streams of revenue. It is absolutely a way to make at least $10,000 in a year if you work at it. So number 10 is definitely the craziest one of them all, I feel like. This one's for the ladies, and you can become a surrogate. Now, surrogates can get paid anywhere between $30,000 and $50,000. So for the right person who is okay with giving the ultimate sacrifice of physically caring a child and then giving that child to the parents that, you know, want to be involved in this process, it can be both physically and emotionally draining. So this is not an option that you should take lightly. This is a very, very big deal, and one that's going to impact you for life. So if it's for the right person and you're thinking about, okay, this is a way that I can give back and help somebody and also make a lot of money, it could work for you. Now, these ideas are definitely extreme, but if you're wanting other ideas that can fit into your routine and schedule and maybe aren't so extreme, be sure to check out all of our blog posts, free tools and resources at thecollegeinvestor.com.